If you got one of the black and white programs, you know, summertime colors are really sunshiny. Moving on to our next piece. When I look at the score of the Schubert piece, I see poetry in the German language and tend to assume this is going to be rather heavy-duty German romanticism from the early 19th century. But then I looked at an English translation and it turned out a little different than I expected. This is a rather arrogant rogue butterfly, definitely a hymn. And he knows what he wants and he's going to get it. Here's a rather stilted literal translation. Why should I not dance? It's no trouble to me, and delightful colors shimmer here in the green. Ever fairer gleam my colorful wings, ever sweeter breathe all the small blossoms. I'm tasting the blossoms, you cannot protect them. Just try and stop me. As the butterfly goes on about his business in this next piece, in the middle section, I think he has noticed a very attractive female butterfly. He pauses for a while to show off his colorful wings, but then he resumes the important business.
Thank you. to be too much of a show-off here, but I want to note that the fourth of these summertime pieces, I will play the entire, my part of it, with just these four fingers.
Make a note. It's called Katy-dids.
So, Summer Dreams by Amy Beach is a suite of six pieces that, to her, represented in music these themes of summer. And she chose poetry to preface each of the pieces. I'll read the poems, and then they'll play. Number one, The Brownies. This is from Shakespeare. Through the house give glimmering light by the dead and drowsy fire. Every elf and fairy sprite hop as light as bird from briar.
Thank you.
Robin Redbreast. In country lanes, the robins sing clear-throated, joyous, swift of wing, from misty dawn to dewy eve, though cares of nesting vex and grieve, their little heart bells ring and ring. Twilight. The birds have hushed themselves to rest, and night comes fast to drop her pall till morn brings life to all. Katy-dids. Walt Whitman. The Katy-did works her chromatic reed on the walnut tree over the well. Thank you. Elfin Tarantelle. Fairies, black, gray, green, and white, yawn, moonshine revelers, and shades of night, by Shakespeare. Good night. Good night. The crimson-scented rose droops low her pretty head, and the little grasses long ago their evening prayers have said. Night's starry eyes are blinking at the moonbeam's silvery light, while the lily hides her golden heart and whispers soft, good night.
Thank you.
We have heard this next song maybe all of your lives. It was originally written by Edith Piaf, and it's one of her signature tunes. And I love what she does with it, but I think my very favorite version of this is what Louis Armstrong does. And this is a transcription of one of his versions.
Thank you.
This next piece is probably the one piece in the program that isn't explicitly a summer song of some kind. We have butterflies and bugs and plants and flowers and stuff. And this one's not explicitly a summertime song, but it's upbeat, and I wanted an excuse to attempt to play it somewhere. So, and these guys were nice enough to let me try. So.
To say, if parts of that sound familiar, which they do to me, it was written the year before American in Paris, and it feels like a study for that particular tune. There's so many little thematic elements that really feel like that, like American in Paris. It's one of my favorite things that Ray practices. I've been in sort of heaven listening to him practice this over and over again. It's great.
Over and over and over.